This is my 2008 BassCat Pantera 4. I'm going to try to give you a look throughout the boat and an overview of it. Show you everything it has. First, do a walk around. It has a Mercury Optimax 200 on it. It is dual console. I'll start at the front, I guess. It's got Minn Kota Fortrex 80. It has the TH Marine cable handle on it. It has side imaging with a Hummingbird 998 up front, and it has the Hydrowave. Got the recessed foot pedal. It has blue water LEDs up front for the red and green. And it has a spotlight from blue water LED. It has the Troll Perfect tension adjustment thing for your trolling motor. There's your switches up front. It has two butt seats. It has the rod buckles on each side of the front. It also has blue water LEDs in yellow on the front deck. It's got three on each side. And it has two up front here, one right there, and one over here. I also have the big ram mount for both units, and they have aluminum plates bolted underneath to it, so it's very strong. And the troll motor also has the aluminum plates also. I'm walking on back. It has your tie downs. It has a 12 volt plug on each side, and there's the horn on this side. Here's on the other side. Dual consoles. Here's the dash. It has the 1198 side imaging unit with the big ram mount. There's your switches. Steering wheel. The Lowrance flasher that I've disconnected that's useless. It has the SmartCraft gauges, so it tells, those two gauges tell everything you need to know. And there's your switches for the lights. Live well switches and your start key. It also has a hot foot, butt board, a little pouch for putting stuff. It has a cigarette lighter back there. There's your power and live well switches. Your Mercury handle, gear shifter. There's your driver's seat. This thing in the middle is for, of course, you got two cup holders. It's got a handle for hanging on for the passenger. And inside of that, it has a place for your throw cushion. The back deck has blue water LED yellow strip on each side. it's got a small one on the back on each side. There's the GPS for the rear unit. Tie downs. It has a 6-inch slide master jack plate, manual adjust, boat buckle tie downs. It's got the yellow strip going around the motor. It has the E-ladder on the jack plate on this side. There's your pump outs. The passenger console is really huge. And I've got some license plates and hats and BassCat stuff that goes with it. But you can see how deep this is. I'm going to put my whole arm to the elbow. There's your passenger rod holder for 5 rods. Just comes up the side here. It has the step on the front with the grab pole. It has a handle, grab pole, big step, small step, and another step. Spare tire. The trailer has the gator hide coating. It has 2 easy troll steps with a yellow light. Fiberglass fenders, 15-inch wheels, Goodyear Marathon tires. Disc brakes on the rear axle. It has the white backup lights, strips going around the back of the fender. It has go light, LED, brake lights. It has full blue water yellow lights under the trailer. And on the prop, I have a 25 pitch trophy 4-blade. The boat will run empty about 69 or 70. Loaded down, tournament ready, it'll run about 66, 67. There's the other step. Now let me hop inside and I'll show you the inside. Here's the front fishing area. Go ahead and turn this depth finder on. You have plenty of room up here with the trolling motor all the way forward. Gives you the maximum deck area. There's your butt seat. There's the depth finder on. Then, up front you have, this is one big box. It's got 2 lids, and the center part is a net holder. This actually goes all the way past the front seat. It's just one big box with 2 lids. It actually goes up to about right here. So it's a huge box. This right here is for your registration and all that. And all these boxes are lighted with white blue water LED light. This is the driver's side rod locker for storage. It doesn't have the rod tubes in it though. It's all lighted. If I can get it to come on, there it goes. These BassCats have mercury switches, and sometimes they can be finicky, so you just kind of have to tap on them or move the rod or the door a little bit. But it's got the white light, so you can have this on both lids open and work on all your tackle at night. That's a super deep storage box. And over here is the passenger side rod locker. It has lights, and it has the rod tubes in it, and you have bulk storage underneath it, so you can store a ton of rods, and it's super deep. Here's these lights. Here's your main storage box for your tackle or whatnot. You see it has lights there, and it's got some under here too. But it's got tackle trays, tackle box trays for your Plano boxes, the front light. Here's a third seat pedestal. This is your cooler. And it's a decent sized cooler, it's not huge. I just washed it, so it's still dripping water a little bit. It's lighted also, with a switch. It has cup holder here and here. It has your dead plate here for your feet. And of course that passenger side just has a foot area. This glove box is lighted also too. Here's the passenger seat. The worst thing about this seat, it's starting to rip right here just from people fishing with me and co-anglers and stuff like that. They're rough on your stuff. Your gas tank is underneath your seats, and there's a window so you can see how much gas you have. Here is the passenger handle, cup holders. This flips up with your throw cushion in here. And there's where you can get to your fuel tank. At the driver's console, I'll go ahead and turn this on. It's a Hummingbird 1198 side imaging. Steering wheel, it's tilt. It has the trim lever here. Mercury smart calf gauges, smart craft gauges. Here's your lights. That turns all the yellow lights on the top of the deck on and underneath the consoles. Then this turns the brightness up, which is daytime, so you can't see them all that great. That's under each console. This actually does nothing. I already put a switch here because I was planning on adding the black lights on it. So this switch does nothing. And this switch here turns the spotlight on up front. You can see this unit just came on. In the back, you have your live wells, which are very deep. I have a culling system I rigged up here. They're also lighted. These live wells are great. I've never had a problem with them. Both of these back boxes are huge. There's your box for the 998, which I bought new. Fire extinguisher. This light, these mercury switches on the back boxes, they work some, but not a whole lot. Mercury switches are not all that great on these BassCats. Here's the passenger side one. That's the box for the 1198. And you can fit a good size tackle bag in these. There's the butt seat. back here for the bilge area. This box is actually removable. Just disconnect the lights there and that strap, and this whole thing pops off. There's your oil cooler. I have three diehard 31 series PM1 batteries. One for your cranking and two for the trolling motor. There's your pumps, which are easily accessible. This is all lighted. It works sometimes also. The light switch, or the light plug. C-Star hydraulic steering. There's also two blue water lights in yellow in the jack plate, so the jack plate glows yellow. So this boat is lighted inside and out and under the trailer. Now let me get out and we will start the motor. Let's turn the water on. We'll get the motor started. Put the kill, turn this kill switch to run. That might help. Hours on the motor. The motor is what came with the boat brand new. Now I'm going to show you anything that I know of wrong with the boat. Right here, I don't know if you can see it, there's a nick right there. Let's see. There's three small little nicks right here. There's one, and there's one. That's from a dock. Right here on the motor, this is scratched up a little bit. There is a small nick. Right here is a very small nick. On the trailer, right here, actually dropped off a ramp and it drug coming back up. There's that. Right here on each side, that's where the last owner and me both have gotten, put the trailer on crooked, or put the boat on the trailer crooked, and scuffed up the fenders a little bit. same way over here. On the hole, there's your normal scratches from just shallow water fishing. There's a scratch right here, small scratch, which some of these scratches could be buffed out, I'm sure. There's a few little nicks here. There's some more scratches under here, but I don't know how good you can see them. It's just part of using a boat. But that's about it. There's not much wrong with this boat. It's everything works perfectly. It's in great condition. Here is all the trailer lights lit up right now. You see there's a bunch of lights under the trailer. There's the one on the step. There's a strip on the back here. Then the brake light is also LED. It's a glow light. Let me turn the deck lights on for you. So that's on dim right there. Then as I turn the knob, they'll brighten up. And that's full brightness right there. There's a strip under each console, so the whole cockpit area glows. And there's also two in the jack plate, so it glows. Now I'll turn on the nav lights. You can see you have your red and green nav lights up front. So there's no need to even have the one that comes with the boat, the little short pole. I'll turn those off. I'll turn the spotlight on up front. Truck's in the way, but you get to see. It's a very bright light, and it makes a perfect circle. I have it in reverse now, so it'll be showing the reverse lights on the trailer. And they wrap around the fender so you can get side light and back light. I'm inside the boat now, and I'll show you the lights in some of the boxes. There's both your rod lockers. And I'll turn these lights on top of the doors on also. You can see how you can sit on the front deck and work on your tackle in the dark. It lights up the whole front deck. Here's your front box. It's a little tricky to get it to light up sometimes. There it goes. And the center net holder also lights up. Here's the cooler. It lights up. Glove box. Here's the live wells. Here's the driver's rear box. There it goes. Like I said, those mercury switchers are not the best, but that's what BassCat does. Here's the passenger side box. Let's see if it'll work. There it goes. Here's the bilge area. There it goes.